Yeah, they scared them all out.
You're recording right now.
This is Alex from Mundo 2, by the way. He's opening for Paul.
Is it here or here?
Alex is opening for Paul.
Alex,
¿cómo estás,
man?
Bien, gracias.
Take that?
Yeah,
absolutely.
Who's your cohort?
That sounds so dirty.
Short.
Oh, they're listening. It's worth it, right?
Sure, there's another chair back there. Please use it. Somebody can use that.
It's a pepper grinder.
You look really at home with those utensils. You're like,
3 minutes. Oye, ¿cómo va?
Mi lindo.
Qué ritmo bueno para gozar. Mulato.
There's not a Latin person in the world that uses this at home. What is this?
It's fat.
It's fat in a can.
It's fat in a can.
Oh, wow.
You know?
It also,
I knew a fat girl.
It also,
they sit there and they say fat free. Look at the first ingredient.
Fat.
Oil.
It's also good for the bald spots.
Yeah.
Hey.
You okay around the house?
Well, Mrs. Johnson, I think you're using too much sugar.
Look at that.
Bones
all right.
From Star Trek. Cover,
huh?
Yeah. Oh, cool. Look at this. And then I saw God.
Ay, ay, ay.
Ay, ay, ay.
This is going to be on our website.
Oh, yeah?
You cook it on our website.
I didn't even know you had a website.
I got a website.
It's in the garage. It's got a spider in it.
So
I don't know anything about the net.
Well,
last net I used was when I was frying the McDonald's. You know, they make you wear a net.
Hey, Craig, your tickets are here, and they're for 11 o'clock show tonight.
And come on down, Craig.
And ask Paul who he thinks is going to win.
How quickly do you want him to cook this dinner?
It's not just for Latinos anymore.
Well, yeah, let's get it going. We'll start. We only got about a minute and a half.
Come on, baby.
He's pulled
up.
No, yours. Go ahead.
What is he going to cook it? What are you cooking?
He's going to do a...
No,
this is Noel. Noel, this one.
Yeah?
Just vodka. It's a vodka shrimp dish.
Oh.
All right, here we go.
Here we are.
What are my cans? You took my cans?
All right. You got another set?
Put them on.
No, we only have those.
Yeah, you can use them. Pretty much know what to say.
Hey, Paul.
Al.
How are you? It looks just like being in a kitchen, a small room with everybody in it.
Where's my
seat at?
Nah, I don't care.
Let's make it official here.
There I don't have go. To be funny
we're
now.
We're late and we're sorry.
Yes. Yes. Hey, man. Good. Who's this? Hey, buddy, what's going on? Michael, you're gonna have to do it in about 10 minutes. Will you please? Okay, buddy.
Right. Top heavy thought there.
Yeah, well, you gotta sit just right.
It's top heavy like you.
I think I'm more bottom heavy. Believe it or not.
Ask him what his thoughts are.
Gotcha.
Oh, baby, I have thoughts.
I'm glad that you're aware of my reality.
We're doing this and that.
Everything is
so you're just going to throw shrimp in at the same time, screw it up about a minute. So
9:40 with the Rock and Roll Morning Show. Please welcome to the show Paul Rodriguez.
Yeah.
Hello. 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 Some people say goodbye. I say hello.
How you doing, Paul?
I'm doing well.
Paul
I'm doing
and
well.
Two shows over at the Lance Burton Theater in the beautiful Monte Carlo Hotel tonight.
I know they call it the Lance Burton Theater right now, and but we're gonna do something different about that. Tonight I'm gonna go in there and I'm gonna make all his clothing disappear. Yeah, I'm gonna. You know, I worked at the MGM, the FX show with Tommy Toon.
Oh yeah.
And I walked into his dressing room, right?
Oh no.
And he has these really, you know, Liberace kind of clothing. I don't need to go any further. I think you folks are smart enough to know what I'm talking about.
Sure.
So I walked out there with like this big old red, you know, rhinestone head to toe thing. I walked out there and the whole audience that was out there to see me went, oh, I think he went Cinco de Mayo on us. Anyways, I get to use Lance Burton's dressing room, man.
Nice.
And yeah, he's a great magician, you know, and he could make me disappear. But for those of you listening right now to us on Smell a Radio, I've got shrimp on the barbie for you.
We've got the guys from chef.com here, and
yeah.
Going to their website.
I'm cooking.
What are you making there?
I'm making shrimp.
Vodka shrimp.
I'm making vodka shrimp for all you young ladies out there who are attractive and lonely and have been mistreated by your man who doesn't cook, who doesn't massage your back, who doesn't cuddle. You know, because women are always accusing that men, we don't talk about our feelings. Ladies, that's not true. We do talk about our feelings. For example, I was just telling my friend Alex Raimundo the other day, you know how men talk about their feelings? We go, hey, how you feeling? Can you drive? That's how we talk about our feelings. So women, you go into detail. We don't. Because let's face it, you know, guys, we don't have that much equipment, and let's face it, if we're going to have sex, it's pretty much all up to you, because God knows we're willing. See, I believe that a woman can look at a man from far away. She doesn't have to talk to him. A woman can look at a man and knows if she would ever be with him or not.
True. Very true.
Men, we don't even have to look at her. I can tell you right now. That's the kind of pigs we are. God bless us all. Anyways, for those of you that can't see us on the website, you can see us, right?
Yeah, in about four days it'll be up.
In about 4 days?
Yeah.
Oh, well, God knows technology has reached Vegas. Anyways, the shrimp is getting really pink, which is one of my favorite colors. Listen up.
Hey,
Alex Raimundo, put the mushrooms in.
Vamos.
All right, empty the mushrooms. For those of you out there, you know, I'm no galloping gourmet, but you can't mess this up.
Mushrooms weren't even in the dish. So
the mushrooms, the salsa is in. We're going to put a little salt, a little pepper.
What is that you're using? What was that?
And these mushrooms come from cow patties, so you know you're going to be seeing things. You're going to be seeing wild coyotes. Hey, man, thanks a lot, man. It's a pleasure to be on your show.
Thanks for coming.
You always have, like, really awesome people here, and I'm honored, man, you know.
Who's your buddy here? Who's your buddy?
Well, you know, his name is Alex Raimundo.
Hey, how you doing?
He has I guarantee you this. Here's a prediction. Alex Raimundo one day will be going, who was Alex Raimundo with the last time he was here? He's got a deal at the UPN, the underpaid Negro station. he's got a... Oh, was that funny? Or are you just teasing me? Well, are there any other people at UPN? Anyways, he's got a deal. He's got his own show. And I'm just trying to catch up to him. He's opening my show here at the Monte Carlo. Right.
Yeah, we're doing the show here.
So that, you know, when he becomes like a big... Because I've had big stars open for me, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, Martin Lawrence used to open for me.
Yeah.
And now, apparently, he's had, you know, problems. You know, everybody's going, oh, yeah, he...
With that coma thing?
Yeah, he was going... Yeah, he was running to lose weight. Yeah, I'm saying it was about 20 pounds of crack. But what do I know? You know?
Look. He was running from the LAPD.
Yeah, yeah. Anyone that's at a car wash and pulls out a gun, something's in your system. Call me Dr. Laura. Let me go out on a limb here. But he used to open for me, you know, and seems like everybody that opens for me eventually becomes a way bigger star than I'll ever be. And that's what's going to happen to Alex Raimundo. So, Alex, come on, man. Be kind to me.
Nicer words couldn't be said. What a nice guy. And he's making me breakfast. You like that?
Hey. Those are done. You can try one.
Hey, wait a minute. They're not done yet. Hey, the shrimp is fine, man. Here, try some of this.
He's been cooking the
tastes like chicken. All right, you get this? Hey, here's someone with girth.
Incredible shrinking Rick.
Gracias, mijo.
All right, mijo. You know he doesn't call just anyone that. Mijo, for those of you who are not of Spanish, you know, descent. For those of you
Sorry
who are Spanish challenged, let me just tell you, mijo means my dear boy. Which I don't know what he means about that. For those of you listening to this radio station, and I always get this question, they're always going, look, we kind of like your show, but it's all going to be in Spanish, because, you know, I'm from Michigan, and I'm from Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, and me and the wife, you know, we've seen you on HBO, but, you know, we don't want to pay that kind of ticket and just get, like, 10% of the show. No, man, it's in English. Well, you know, that's what I call English. As best as I can speak English, it's in English. So for those of you who can't get tickets to see Siegfried and Roy, who, by the way,
His first name is Ham, isn't it?
Now, I understand that Siegfried and Roy have had a falling out, shall we say? Yeah, that's the big news, yeah. They just stayed together for the Tigers. They're going to separate until they get through college. I don't know. I actually owe that line to Conan O'Brien, one of the funniest lines I heard. Anyways, Siegfried and Roy, who God knows are just very, you know, macho guys.
Oh, yeah, right.
I don't think there's no secret here. Why lie? Let's face it. With that kind of money, they should be, like, surrounded with chicks. If Keith Richards can get laid, Siegfried and Roy should have a shot, okay? If you notice, there's a reason why their tigers are white.
Scared.
Yeah, they're scared to be left alone with him. You know, if those tigers could talk, they would say things like, they do crazy things to us when the public is gone. Anyways, God knows that Germans are really known for stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
The funniest people on the planet. Hey, I just finished my shrimp for those of you listening to me right here on the comp.
All right. What's it look like?
Oh, Andy's man. Get some.
Yeah.
Hey, if there's, hey, look, Mexicans just don't only wash dishes, Holmes. I went to a... You know, Mexicans work in every hotel. I went to a sushi bar, and this is really ridiculous. I saw two guys from Oaxaca with scotch tape on their eyes. I'm serious. I said, what part of Japan are you from? And they said, Guadalajara. Anyways, what can I tell you? Go ahead,
Rodriguez.
Jump in.
We're going to be back in 1 second.
Two.
I do.
So how'd you do?
That's really good.
This is fat-free.
What'd you season it with?
It's got soy sauce, garlic, hot sauce, honey, and vodka.
Vodka.
It's a chicha.
Everybody
winds
up. Vodka!
Vodka.
Flavors here.
Good.
It's up.
There's no fat.
It's a shrimp, vodka, and paraquat.
Huh?
Straight paraquat.
No, I'm going to get you if I'm lucky.
If I'm lucky.
Yeah, well, you know, not as funny as Richard, but but I can use this. Yeah, man.
Did you guys talk about the fight, I guess?
Yes. Oh, hey, OMP, 92.3. Don't change your dial, I'm just kidding.
Wow. Because, you know, there's some people going, oh, another Spanish station. Jesus, another Spanish. Aren't there enough? What's going on? You know, somebody ought to tighten up that border.
No, folks. You're listening to Comp 92.3. Nothing has changed. It's just that they got, you know, under the affirmative action program, they got me here.
It's
happening.
We've been cooking vodka shrimp that's going to be on the cheflive.com website
here
pretty quick.
Yeah, man, hook up to that website, is it? You know, you're going to see me cook, which is something I haven't done since I was in prison. You know, and let me tell you, I was in prison with Robert Downey Jr.
Oh.
I was, and I want to tell you, that little tramp is good. He's good in bed, oh yeah.
Oh,
I flipped him like a burger. I tossed him like a salad. Yeah. I almost wanted to commit another crime just to stay there a little longer. he was tighter than getting credit. Anyways, some of you will get these jokes later.
They said he's paying people in prison to take care of him. He's paying people, like, to take care of him.
Oh, yes,
guys.
Yes, he is. He's paying quite a bit. And he's paid through the butt.
You know, hey.
Just kidding. For those of you fans out there, I'm just joking. I wish him well, you know.
Yeah, right.
I only wish I could afford his drug problem. All right, ask me some poignant questions. Everybody wants to know.
What do you like in the fight Saturday?
Hey! Hey!
What? Is he fighting too?
No, I'll tell you what. I think it's going to be a great fight. Everybody says that. But, you know, you got to go with the Mexican boy. He's more motivated. He's got a white woman to take care of. And those are expensive. You know, he's dating some girl from Baywatch or something, right? You know, those are costly. You know, I had one on loan for a while there, and, you know, I couldn't afford it. So, you know, he's motivated, you know. I think Trinidad, I know them both, and I kid with both of them. I've known De La Hoya since he was like 13 years old. Used to hang out and come out on my show, and I used to go down and see him at Salesian Boys Club. He's a great kid, and for some reason, everybody's always, you know, Latinos are always divided. They're always wishing him, they boo him, they're always wishing him ill. But I'm telling you, De La Hoya and Five, well, in reality, whoever connects first, Because they're both strong. Yeah. You know, because, you know, Trinidad's been tagged before, and I'm certainly no fight expert, you know, but, you know, blood's thicker than guacamole, and I gotta go with De La Hoya, you know?
All right.
Because if De La Hoya doesn't win, I'm gonna have to put up with like 2 years from all my Puerto Rican friends talking a lot of, you know, and Puerto Ricans talk a lot faster than Mexicans. Oye, nene, tú sabes que ese chico que tú no vas a ganarle, que va a que ve, you know? I said, listen, I love losing, but I don't know what you're talking about. Slow down, take a quaalude, let me understand what you're saying. But, you know, everyone's always been waiting for De La Hoya to lose. They bet against De La Hoya, and nobody's ever gotten rich. The great thing about this fight is that these two guys are in their prime. You know, when De La Hoya fought Chavez, the 87 Chavez and the 97 De La Hoya would have been a great fight. Chavez was out of his prime. But the great thing about this fight is that they're both in their prime. They're approximately the same height. They have 72 arm reach, unless they're really excited. And they, this is a great fight. This is a great fight, and I will be there. And but I'm looking forward to the you know, there's some women gonna fight, you know.
Oh yeah, is there chick fights on the card?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Chick fights. Let us.
The girl posting Playboy.
Yeah.
Oh, St. John.
Yeah, you know. Let us be pigs about this. But you know what? I think the reason why the WNBA ain't taking off is because, well, you know. I'm a pig, but I think they should play in pumps and Victoria's underwear. I pay attention, you know. You know, unfortunately, most of them, you know, don't bat the way nature would like them to bat. You know.
And let's be honest. As everybody said, let's be honest. The only reason we watch the women's sports is we're looking for that breast to fall out.
Wait, come on, baby. Oh, yeah.
No. I like it when they get like a chest shot, and they punch him, like they'll punch in one breast and the other one like doubles in size. it's like watching a cartoon.
Only in Vegas.
Only in Vegas. But it's gonna be a hell of a fight, you know. And I'm here to make money. Let's face it, which I'm not, because
you're gonna bet it all on the fight.
Yeah, I'm gonna bet it all on the fight, you know. Hey, you know, I live in a trailer park. I don't mind telling you. It's a nice trailer park, though, you know. Hey, you know, most of my neighbors are white. And, missing teeth. Oh, I'm sorry. Most of your audience is right about now going, I've had it with this Mexican. I'm getting a high-power rifle and going to the nearest Baptist church. Hopefully he'll be there. I'm sorry. What can I tell you?
Alex Raimundo.
Yeah, Alex, talk.
Here. Yeah, it's my second time to Vegas with Paul. We're having a great time. You gotta love this city because it legalized prostitution, more churches per capita. I read that yesterday. I'm thinking altar boys gotta be making a killing in this town.
I still don't get
it. You don't
one.
Get it. It's because he's an altar boy. Don't
I don't get it, but
he
all right.
He was altered as a
go
boy.
Go with it. No, what I like about, you know, God forbid I should ever be homeless, but if you've ever heard my act, chances are I will be. But, you know, this must be like the best place on earth to be homeless. If I were homeless, I wouldn't pick Los Angeles or Cleveland. Or it has the steadiest weather. I just like live in a dumpster behind the Monte Carlo.
Yeah.
People throw away like a lot of food or any one of these hotels, right? They throw more food away in this town than most people in like in third world countries eat, you know. So
no kidding.
I would just, you know, park myself right behind the circus buffet, and I just, you know, pig out. You know, this is the only city where like you see like steaks for $1.99.
Oh yeah.
Steak for $1.99. I'm talking about in the rest of the world, shoe leather is $3 a foot. You know? This is a great city, man.
This is Paul Rodriguez, who's going to be at the Lance Burton Theater tonight, tomorrow night, Monte Carlo, 11 o'clock show, only one show per night. I got tickets to give away this morning. So if you want to go, 876-FM-92, pound-93, just print PCS digital phone, and we'll pick up the call, the price of the call. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you, boss.
Gentlemen. Thanks, Alex.
And, thanks, everybody out there. Have a great day.
Thanks to the guys from ChefLive.com.
Thanks for having us
here.
Chef Rick, thank you.
They're going to start their tour of the country. Clock on the floor says 10:02, still keeping perfect time despite the abuse. That's going to count for me, Craig Williams, Sweet Al, and Andy Kay as well. Hey, join us out in Pahrump this weekend. We got parade at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, the Sexy Legs Contest, arm wrestling tournament, the road.
Two of them didn't make it back. Digital camera.
Yeah, you just took a picture of yourself.
Good one.
then.
Man, you are shaking like a
thing. Yeah, drink some more.
That's it. We're snap.
That's not working. That's not working.
Thanks a lot, fellas.
We can email you.
Good energy.
I can see one of those rocks guys.
How did you start growing it?
Okay. Great, thank you. Napkin out of here.
Can I at least show you directly about the shifting part?
Sure. What kind of problem do you think it is?
Like I said before, I have no clue. It's probably a fuel delivery, but we don't work on rotary.
But it does it on when you're not, it does when you're deaccelerating, when you're just posting. So it can't be fuel.
Okay.
Fair enough?
No, but.
No, I mean, how would it be a fuel thing if you're not adding fuel?
Because we do not.
That's not what I asked you. I asked.
Just show her.
The answer to your question is I don't know.
You don't know.
Correct.
Any idea what's wrong with the car?
Absolutely correct.
Okay.
But you don't think that we're telling the truth that we said it was working better when we brought it in than afterwards?
It doesn't matter if it was working better before. We have a drivability problem.
Well, that doesn't mean anything. That's just a buzzword, for Christ's sakes. You know that.
Buzzword.
A buzzword means that it's a word to throw off other people. Feel that?
See, it doesn't go into gear.
It's not supposed to. Well, we'll take the car and we'll have it fixed. And if it's your bag, I'll be back.
Thanks. So I will follow you.
Yeah, where are we gonna go? Hi, Mom. I was supposed to have a rock done for you, and it turns out the guy who does the rocks isn't legitimate. So I'm starting on a coconut for you. I'm making it myself. It's going to be a fish. So this is how far I've gotten. I've worked on it for about, 6 hours so far. So that's where it is right now. You can turn it off now.